Good afternoon. Welcome to Independent Presbyterian Church. My name is Jeff McClellan, and I'm the Director of Music and Fine Arts here at IPC. I want to thank you for being with us today for this second recital of the 58th season of the November Organ Recital series. As always, these recitals are presented as a gift to the community of Birmingham, and all donations received will help to ensure the future of the series. Please make plans to return next week as we continue the 2022 series. I am most pleased to present to you Ken Cowan to perform for us today. He is indeed one of the premier performers in the world, and we are blessed to have him here again at IPC. He dedicated this organ 10 years ago to a standing room only crowd, and he managed to use every sound on the organ with a dazzling display of technique and innate musicality that frankly few people possess. Can you tell that I'm a fan? Besides performing around the world, Ken is professor of organ at Rice University and artist in residence at Palmer Memorial Episcopal Church, both in Houston, Texas. You can read more about him on the World Wide Web. I don't think people refer to it that much anymore, but that's okay. Following the recital, you are invited to a reception in the parlor through these doors on your right. It is going to happen this week. I checked on it, so we're fine. Here you can meet our artist and enjoy a cookie or two. Now, please take a moment to silence your electronic devices. And without further delay, I now proudly present to you Ken Cowan.
Thank you. It's so good to be back here at Independent Presbyterian Church. It is so rare that I get to play an instrument that is this comprehensive and just really wonderful in every way. So it has been a real treat not only to get caught up with old friends here, but also to get reacquainted with this seemingly old friend now, 10 years later, Dobson Instrument. We're continuing now with music that will explore some of the more soft and tranquil sides of the instrument, the Pastorale by Roger Ducasse. I wrote some program notes for you, so I won't get into all of the details, but needless to say, this piece depicts a scene in nature where we begin on a tranquil, sunny day, and then a storm arrives and things start to get stirred up. You can hear imitations of birds as they are tweeting away here and there, rustling leaves, wind, then finally thunder, a few bolts of lightning, some final droplets of rain, and then the tranquility of the beginning returns.
Thank you.
have a rather fun piece by Gunnar Edenstam in a style I think you'll find contrasting and really mixed with genres even beyond classical. Jokking originates in Scandinavian folk music in the northern part of Scandinavia. And so, as you might be able to read, the idea is that you can evoke a person, a place, or a thing. That is to say, you yoke it, you don't yoke about it. And so, whatever it is that the subject was here, I think must have been at least good-natured and maybe quite jolly. You'll hear this theme developed throughout. The musical figures that he comes up with, I think, conjure really nicely the kind of fairy tale landscape we need for this kind of music.
Thank you.
Rochelle Laurent has become, I think, just a fantastic voice in composition for the organ over about the past 30 years now. She refers to herself as a disciple of Raymond Davalouis, who was organist at St. Joseph's Oratory in Montreal for years. And Rachel lived first in Montreal, then moved to Ottawa several years ago now. And her music reflects her personality, which is extremely vivacious and fun-loving. In the case of the Etude Caprice, Opus 66, she nicknamed it Beelzebub's Laugh because she was looking for themes to write on and discovered a kind of artistic rendering of the character or caricature, Beelzebub. And she sent it to me in the mail to say, okay, these are the subject for the theme, and the first one is going to imitate the kind of sinister laughter of this fly. So as if to say, ha ha ha, and you're going to hear that rhythm throughout the piece, but the first three notes are that. Then secondly, she illustrates the idea of this buzzing, pesky, fly-like creature with a lot of the accompanimental ideas that come out in the piece. And so that not all of the themes are angular, she then introduces a more kind of almost jazz-like second theme that's very lyric and played on the more lush side of the organ's sounds.
Thank you.
I've always been a great fan of Max Reger's organ music, and Hallelujah, Gott zu loben is one of his, I would say, sunniest chorale fantasias as far as character, largely because of its really exuberant theme. It's a hymn version of Psalm 146, and what Reger set out to do was to evoke the mood of successive verses of that psalm in music. So you'll hear a kind of stormy introduction that introduces the whole proceedings. And then finally, the chaos of the opening clears away and you'll hear the theme starting to emerge in the bass. It builds up to a fairly big climax at the end of the first verse. And then we cut things back somewhat and you're gonna hear some sort of strange leaping ideas accompanying in the bass. And that's because the second verse of the text is talking about not putting your trust in princes, that is to say the ruling class, so it's kind of apt for the season, right? And Reger evokes that kind of unsettled mood. Then subsequent verses are tranquil. When we're talking about God the Creator, things start to emerge and build up in their intensity. And then finally, a very meditative variation precedes the final kind of Alleluia. You're gonna hear a leaping idea coming in a fugue, which is to say a chase. And you'll hear other voices appearing to chase after it one by one. You can imagine a kind of angelic chorus beginning to spin around until finally that theme that ties the whole piece together emerges once again in the bass. And we'll try to include about every bass pipe in the organ by the end of it. I'll play you the theme before we start, just so you know what you're listening for. We didn't have any Bach today, so this is the jig fugue.